When you love someone, you want to offer him or her something. Something beautiful. Something that you are sure he will like or she will like. And what is the best thing you can offer him or her when we love him or her so much? That is my question. Maybe you think that you can go to the supermarket and buy something, but that may not be the best thing you can offer him or her. We should think a little bit more about that. What is the most precious thing that you can offer him or her, the person we love so much? I know a young man of 11. He's not happy. His father is very rich. His father is a businessman, having a lot of money. And yet, everything that his father gave him did not make him happy. His father is extremely rich, and he could afford to buy anything for his son. But the young man did not seem to need anything at all. He was unhappy because his father is so busy. When you are a businessman like that, you do not have the time for yourself, for your wife, for your children. And that is why the young man was unhappy. His father did not have the time for him, for his mother. And that is why that morning the gentleman asked him, "My son, tomorrow will be your birthday, that's right? What do you want? I will buy it for you." But the young man did not know what to answer because he did not need anything. Even an electric train or a scooter, motorbike. But after some reflection, he found out the answer. "Daddy, it's you that I want." Because his father is so busy, he's caught up with his business. He thinks too much about the stock markets and things like that. And he could not have enough time for himself, for his wife and his son. "Daddy, that's you that I want. I want your presence." Well, he has a father, but he does not feel that he has a father because his father is not available to him. So if his father has gone and practiced mindfulness, he would know what to do. He would go back to his breathing, and breathing in mindfully, breathing out mindfully, bringing his mind home to his body, and become fully present. And then his father would look into the eyes of his son and say, "Darling, my son, I'm here for you." And that is the best kind of gift. That's the best kind of present that you can make to your beloved one. So according to this practice, the best present you can make to your beloved one is your true presence. You have to be there. I'd like to ask you a question. How can you love if you are not there? To love means to be there. And the practice of mindfulness can help you to be truly there in the here and the now for your beloved one. And it's not difficult. You need only to breathe in mindfully and bring your mind home to your body and stop all your thinking, and suddenly you are there, mind and body together. And you have something very precious to offer him or her. And that is why the first mantra that we practice in Plum Ridge is, darling, I'm here for you. And you do not have to practice it in Sanskrit or Tibetan. You can practice it in English. Darling, I'm here for you. But in order to be there, you have to practice. You have to stop your thinking about the past, about the future. You have to stop your projects, your worries, your anger. You have to ride on your in-breath to go home to yourself. And that may take only 3 or 4 seconds for you to stop your thinking and bring your mind home to your body and become fully present. And you can go to him or to her and look into his eyes or her eyes and pronounce the first mantra. Darling, I'm here for you. Because you are truly there, that is why the mantra is real. If you are not there, the mantra will not work. But if you are truly there, mind and body together, I assure you that the mantra will work. And that will make the other person happy. And the most wonderful thing is that even if that person is not physically in front of you, you can still practice. You can use your mobile telephone and breathing in and out mindfully. You compose a number. And when you hear his voice, and you practice the mantra, Daddy, I know you are there. I am here for you. I am truly here for you, or mommy, or anyone that you love. And the first mantra is, darling, I am here for you. And we should all memorize that mantra in order to practice. If we are a lover, if we truly love someone, we have to be there for him or for her. And that is not too difficult. That is meditation. That's not difficult. It does not take time. It does not take money. We need only one thing, mindfulness. Because mindfulness helps you to be there, fully alive, fully present. And with that true presence, we can offer to our beloved one.